This video will demonstrate Houdini's flip solver using the flip tank shelf preset. This preset will generate a network of nodes which will create a half-filled box of flip fluid material with proper boundary conditions to contain the fluid in a box, which we now see in the viewport. Let's take a look at some of the parameters that are available to us. So here we have size, which controls the dimension of our fluid tank. Let's make it a bit bigger, and we'll turn off the ortho grid. Let's move the tank upwards, and you may have noticed that our fluid material is getting clipped when we move it. We can adjust the level to compensate here, but let's keep it at this height. Let's jump back to object level by hitting the U key, and we'll take a look at our water. Change the playback to real time first, and then we'll hit play. Nothing's happening. That's because we need to drop down in geometry first, so let's make a sphere. Change the radius, and we're going to move it a bit higher. We're going to turn the sphere into an RBD object. And now we can hit play. Cool, the default settings are already giving us pretty nice results. Let's go and change a few parameters and see what we get. Let's increase the height of the tank so that our fluid doesn't get clipped. Use the handle tool to pull up the tank. Hit the U key to go back up object level, then double-click to go into the AutoDop network, and then hit the L key to lay out the nodal network. We have to change the value of the feedback scale to 1 so that we enable the feedback of forces applied to objects in the scene. In this case, our ball against the fluid. We're going to make the ball float on the surface. Now we'll change the weight of the ball to make it float. Change the density to 350. Let's see what we get. Let's make it a bit heavier, so go back to density and change the value to 500. And play it back again. Nice, now let's crank up the density to make a big splash. We'll move the ball up higher. And we can move the ball up here, or we can go back to object level, hit the T key, and then move it up with the handle. Go back to frame 1. And one more thing, we're going to make the ball move faster down, so let's change the velocity to minus 50. Now we can play back. So those few frames give us a pretty good idea of what to expect. Let's just take a quick peek at what the fluid looks like. We'll go back up to object level, so hit the U key. We're going to quickly jump to the fluid tank fluid node, double click to go inside. So you can see that we have the display flag set to the DOP import node. Let's Alt and left mouse button click on the display flag of the render node. Here's the fluid shape at render time. The particles are only a preview for us to do our edits on. Let's go back to our previous settings, so you can Control and left mouse button click on the render node to set it back as a render flag. Let's take a look at some pre-cooked ball drop sims in mPlay. There are many other things you can achieve with the flip solver, so check out the presets in the particle fluid shelf and see what you can do with just a few clicks.